Let us continue with the chapter 1, the living world, the three domains of life, the advancement in the molecular techniques and biochemical assays has led to a new classification, the three domain classification. Three domain classification was proposed by the scientist called as Carl Woos in the year 1977 and his co-workers. According to him, he classified the entire animal kingdom into three domains, the archaea, the bacteria and the eukarya. Let us move on to the three domain system. The three domain system adds the taxon domain, which is higher than the kingdom. This system emphasizes the separation of the prokaryotes. So the prokaryotes are separated into two domains, the bacteria and the archaea. So these constitute the two domains. So here all the eukaryotes are placed in a domain called as the eukarya. So eukarya includes all the plants, animals and the fungi. Archaea has some similarity in common with the eukarya when compared to the bacteria. Same way, the archaea has some difference. It shows difference from the bacteria in the cell wall composition, as well as it differs from the bacteria and the eukaryote in membrane composition and rRNA types. Now let us go into the first domain called as the domain archaea. The domain includes all the single-celled organisms, the prokaryotes, which have the ability to grow in the extreme conditions like the volcano vents, hot springs and polar ice caps. Hence they are called as the extremophiles. So all the organisms that are classified in the domain archaea are capable of growing in extreme conditions like the volcano vents, hot springs and polar ice caps. So these are some unicellular organisms. So here you can see the image of the extremophiles, which can grow in the extreme conditions of the volcano vent as well as the hot springs. Now they are capable of synthesizing their food without the sunlight and oxygen by utilizing hydrogen sulfide and other chemical from the volcanic vents. So accordingly, these extremophiles can be classified as methanogens. Some of them produce methane. So what are methanogens? The archaea that is responsible for producing the methane is called as a methanogen. Some of them are called to be the halophiles. They can grow in the salty environment. So halophiles are the ones which can grow in the salty environment. Then you have the thermoacidophiles, which thrive in the acidic environment and at a very high temperature, that is especially near the volcanic vent. And there are some extremophiles which can grow in the extreme polar regions or extreme cold conditions in the polar regions. The next domain is the domain bacteria. Now when you come to the bacteria, they are the prokaryotic organisms and their cell has no definite nucleus. You can very well see the cells do not have a definite nucleus. The DNA exists as a circular chromosome. They do not have any histone associated with it. They do not possess the membrane bound organelle. There are no membrane bound organelle except for the ribosomes. So ribosomes are found here and there, but the double membrane organelles are not found. Their cell all contain the peptidoglycans. The types of bacteria. The bacteria are of different types. Some of them are called to be the decomposers. They help in the decay and decomposition. Some of the bacteria are very beneficial. The beneficial bacteria are called as the probiotic bacteria. A good example of the probiotic bacteria is the curd. The curd is a probiotic, which are friendly bacteria and they can improve the health. Example, lactobacillus. The harmful pathogenic bacteria are responsible for causing diseases. The cyanobacteria are the photosynthetic blue-green algae which produce oxygen. So these had a key role to play in the changes in the atmospheric oxygen levels from the anaerobic to aerobic during the early geologic period. So in the early period, cyanobacteria were very common and they were able to increase atmospheric oxygen level. The domain eukarya includes all the eukaryotes. Eukaryotes are animals which have true nucleus and membrane-bound organelles. DNA in the nucleus is arranged as a linear chromosome with histone proteins. The ribosomes in the cytoplasm is ATS type, and in the chloroplast and mitochondria it is 70S type of ribosome. The animals in this domain are classified under the kingdoms, namely the protista, the fungi, the plantae and the animalia. So it was Cavalier Smith in 1987 who revised the six kingdom system to seven kingdom system. The concept of super kingdom was introduced and revised to seven kingdom classification. The six kingdom classification is actually divided into two super kingdoms, the prokaryota and the eukaryota, and the seven kingdoms to two prokaryotic kingdoms, the eukaryota and the archaebacteria included under two prokaryotic kingdom, and five eukaryotic kingdoms like the protozoa, chromista, fungi, plantae and animalia. Later on it was revised to the eight kingdom system of classification. So with that we come to the close of the classification. Now we continue with the taxonomic hierarchy in the next video class. Thank you, children.